Atlantis Life Science for a better life.
Okay, leo hii tumetembelea Mbugwa Farm ambayo iko maeneo ya Limuru. Mbugwa Farm iko located hapa Kabete constituency, na tuko na the farm manager mwenye ako in charge ya Mbugwa Farm. Nitampatia hii fursa ajitambulishe.
Kwa majina ni John Mbugwa, ndio nimesimamia hii farm. Hii historia hii farm ilianza na ng'ombe wawili ambao tulipewa na wazazi. Kutoka hapo ndio sasa tukaanza ile mambo ya kubadilisha ile breed. Sasa hao wawili toka hapa ile sexed ndio wakazaa kike, hatukuwauza, bado wakawa wanaendelea wakipata wakitaka ndume, tunawapa ile sexed ndio sasa ile iende ikiongezeka kila mara mpaka pale sasa ambapo tumefika. Ndio sasa unaona wamekuwa wengi ni wakuzaliwa hapa.
Lengo lako kuu haswa ni kuna nia ya kufika wapi?
Ile lengo langu ni iwe niko na ng'ombe wengi, na at least nifike pale ambapo mtu anasema ati ile ati ng'ombe inaweza kupa hata more than 40 liters per day, na wawe wako wengi. At least siku ile nitaona na ati unaweza ingia kwa boma ya ng'ombe na utoke na more than 500 liters per day. Hapo ndio target.
Okay, so wakati ulikuwa umepewa ng'ombe na wazazi, ulikuwa wa production yao ilikuwa kiwango gani?
Ilikuwa ya chini, so maana wengi walikuwa wanatoa 5 wakati amezaa. Ndio amejaribu sana, amefika 7 ama 6. Na wakati huo ndio amezaa, ndio ako peak. Sasa hapo ndio ilikuwa hivyo. Lakini the moment tulianza kubadilisha, unapata inafika 10 na kila ng'ombe ukikamua unaona inafika 10 na at least inaweza kupa maziwa kwa duration, yani refu.
So tangia mwanze, maybe kama kuna changamoto yoyote umekumbana nayo?
Kumekuwa na changamoto nyingi, so manake ya kwanza ni ile hali ya boma. Mpaka wa leo ndio tunangangana tuone kama tutajenga ile boma ya ambazo ziko kisasa. At least tuone kama ng'ombe zitakuwa comfortable. The more zitakuwa comfortable, zita produce maziwa kwa wingi. Na kulikuwa time hiyo kulikuwa hakuna walimu wa kufundisha kila kutembea kama sasa venye mmekuja, ati aje akuje awasomeshe, akwambie hiki. Ni challenges zilikuwa nyingi, so hata madaktari ilikuwa ukimpigia simu yule ambaye yuko inabidi mpaka ungoje hata 2 days. Lakini kwa saa hii wataalamu wameingia, wanakuja wanawafundisha, unakuja unarekebisha. Ukipata wengine wakikuja, unakuja wanawafundisha, unarekebisha hivyo.
So ukiangalia maneno ya magonjwa gani hasa imekuwa ikikutatiza kwa familia yako?
Sana ilikuwa ni mambo ya ugonjwa kama ni foot rot, ambayo tumeenda tukibadilisha ile nyumba, tumekoroga ndio sasa ipunguze ile unyevunyevu kuwa mwingi. Na kwa sahi kama hii ni magonjwa mengine kama ni foot and mouth, lumpy skin, at least sahi madaktari wameanza kuingia, kama kuna outbreak wanajulisha wakulima. Inakuja kama hutategemea huyo wabaye wako naye, unatafuta wako anaenda ananunua dawa na kuja na kunugia. At least sahi tunasema tunajaribu kupambana na kila ugonjwa ambao ukisikika huko, ati sahi tunang'ang'ana.
Unapata kuna wale wakulima ambao bado hawana ile elimu ya kutosha, ila kusema ya kwamba wangependa kuimprove breed zao. Naona wewe from the onset umekuwa ukichagua sexed semen. Lakini kuna wale wakulima ambao bado kwao wanaenda for the what we call conventional semen. Maybe what is your advice kwao?
Wengi katika niko na marafiki, niko na neighbors wangu, ati wao nimeanza kuambia sasa ng'ombe yako ikitaka dume usikibirie kuwapa hii ya kidogo. It is better utumie pesa nyingi ama hiyo kidogo, at least uimprove breed yako. So manake unapata mwingine anakuambia hiyo sijui ni ya pesa nyingi, lakini hata akizaliwa hiyo ng'ombe, hata kama ni hiyo ya pesa kidogo, maziwa hatakutana nayo. Alafu ile ng'ombe ambao ukiwepa ile sexed, umeimprove ile breed. Kwa hivyo ile maziwa ambao utakamua, hata wewe mwenyewe, hata hiyo pesa utahesabu ile ya dume, itakuwa imeshalipa hiyo gharama yote. Yeah.
Excellent. So we are here in Mbugwa Farm, and you can see the history is from two animals, and now as you can see we have quite a number of animals just within a very short period of time. Most of these animals, you can see, they were born in this farm, and he has been using sexed semen to be able to achieve that goal. So from what the interview that you have had, you can see that the first production was at about 5 liters per cow, and right now they have improved quite a great deal, and they have been able to achieve this through breeding the animals and targeting specifically sexed semen, so that they can achieve at the long run pedigree animals that has the capacity of at least giving them 40 liters per cow per day. So we are here basically to just be able to give some advice on how possible this is done. And many a times we all know that everything starts from when the cow is just about to give birth, what we call the transition cow period. So when the cow is just about to give birth, there are so many things that needs to be considered. One of them, of course, starts from steaming up of the animals, so that now as the cow is developing and the conceptus or the fetus is developing in the uterus, there is so much need for feeds and enough feeding, so that the growing fetus grows to the recommended weight, so that when the calf is born, the calf is born at the correct weight. So it starts with how you manage this cow before it calves down. And immediately it calves down, we know that there are so many things that must be considered, so that now you're able to achieve the production potential of that cow in the farm. For example, we know that when the cow just gives birth, a lot of calcium is normally used so that it can initiate the lactation process. And because a lot of calcium was previously used when the calf was developing for the purposes of strong bones and mineralization of those bones, we find out that when the cow calves down, there is some deficiency of calcium in the system, which needs to be supplemented, so that the cow does not go into situations where we have low level of calcium in the body, which will affect the initiation of lactation or the process of milk production and synthesis. So we normally advise that at that particular point in time, we normally supplement those cows at the transition phase with 100 mils of calcium supplement for the first 5 days of the lactation period, beginning when the cow just calves down. So we advise that the cows be given Supercal at a dosage of 100 mils per day for the first 5 days of lactation. Then there comes another challenge. You find that many cows, when they give birth, many a times they have very low level of appetite. And this low level of appetite is normally something that is physiological. It normally happens. So when you don't manage the level of the issue of low appetite by the animals, you realize that many a times this cow starts to mobilize their own reserves, their own body fats. When they mobilize their own body fats, then many a times you find out that it predisposes these cows to what we call metabolic diseases or metabolic conditions. And one of the most common metabolic disease or metabolic condition is normally called ketosis. And ketosis is normally defined as a body wasting disease. How you're able to know that a cow that has just given birth is suffering from ketosis? You realize that when you provide dairy meal to that cow, it refuses to lick dairy meal, what we call concentrates. So when it refuses to lick dairy meal or concentrates before it begins to eat or to consume any forage, then that is very, very significant of the disease that is called ketosis. So because of that, Atlantis Life Science Limited has come up with a unique feeding regime whereby we normally advise farmers to ensure that their cows, immediately they give birth, they are given a product that is called Ketonex. And Ketonex is basically an anti-ketogenic agent. It provides enough energy sufficient for the cow to ensure that it does not mobilize its own body reserves, because we know that when they do that or when they do so, then they predispose the cows to those metabolic diseases. Among them, we have ketosis. The other thing, I know many farmers have that issue whereby when the cow just gives birth and they don't have enough appetite, the biggest challenge will be the issue of negative energy balance. And many farms, they actually give too much concentrates so that now they can compensate for the energy demand by a freshly culled cow. So when they do that, you find out that many a times too much of concentrates also predisposes these cows to so many metabolic conditions and metabolic diseases. One of the most common is normally called acute lactic acidosis. And this acute lactic acidosis is because of too much consumption of concentrates, in the idea that when you give concentrates, you're able to get enough energy for milk production. But if it goes beyond, of course, it depends on the level of production of the cow. Many a times we have a cap of between 6 kg to about 7 kg per cow per day. If it goes beyond that, then it predisposes easily to lactic acidosis because of the presence of too much highly fermentable carbohydrates in the system, which actually affects also the rumen of the cow. So we normally advise that instead of providing too much of the concentrates when the cows just give birth, then we advocate that in this particular regard, you provide the cow with an alternative energy source, which is normally given immediately the cows just give birth. In this regard, we are talking about white energy, and white energy is basically an instant energy source that is normally given to freshly culled cows. The idea is that we want to limit too much consumption of highly fermentable carbohydrates, in this regard concentrates or dairy meal, not to substitute but to supplement. It's like complementary feeding, whereby we actually will not predispose these cows to too much consumption of the concentrates. So white energy is normally given to the cows immediately they give birth at a dosage of 100 grams per cow per day, and this normally targeting to ensure that there is adequate energy for the cows to synthesize milk. And then by default, within a very short time, you find that the milk production actually goes up because the animal does not take some time to mobilize its own body reserves. So whatever the animal is eating per day and the feeds and the food that it consumes per day will be enough for body maintenance and will also be enough for milk production and milk synthesis. This way, we're able to achieve the peak milk production within a very short time, targeting at least 2 months when the cows just give birth. So when able to achieve at least within 2 months, you're able to achieve peak milk production, you find that it will take actually probably about 2-3 months at peak. And this basically increases the profitability of a farm because you're able to at least get more milk than if you are not able to at least go through that regime of introduction of the white energy at a very, very earlier age when the cows just give birth. Last but not least, we all understand that when the cow gives birth, many a times when the in the third lactation, the third gestation period, we find that normally the growing conceptus or the calf that is in the uterus grows at a very high rate. Actually, it's about 800 grams development per day. That means 0.8 kilos per day. So when this happens, you realize that normally this growing conceptus in the uterus normally presses against the rumen. So you find out that when the cow gives birth, the size of the rumen is not normally the same as that of an open cow. That means that cow that is not pregnant. So when the cow gives birth, you get that many a times, because of the issues of low appetite, they normally easily slide into issues of negative energy balance. And when this happens, then when we have low feed intake, or when we have reduced feed intake, then this will affect milk production. So we want to see how possible it is that you can be able to increase milk production from the amount that you're able to get on a daily basis to be able to achieve the maximum level of up to about 40 liters for a pedigree cow. And one of the best ways of doing that is to how to manage the rumen. You need to look at how you're able to manage the rumen in a way that the rumen is well compacted with adequate ruminal microbes, and whereby we have adequate fermentation process, and where we have adequate production of volatile fatty acids, which are the precursors of energy, so that the cow has adequate energy for body maintenance and also adequate energy for milk synthesis. We have what we call camboost, and camboost is basically a supplement that is normally given to freshly culled cows. The target of camboost is to ensure that the rumen's health is well maintained, and then the fermentation process is well enhanced, so that we have adequate production of the volatile fatty acids, which are energy precursors for a pregnant cow. We all know very well that the cow will be having issues of low appetite. So one of the ways is to enhance metabolism and to enhance digestion, so that we have adequate energy, so that the cow is able to be able to produce or synthesize milk in the shortest time possible and to achieve high milk production. So maybe from the owner of the farm, Mbugwa Farm, can you give us maybe your parting shot?
Chenye naweza sema huwa ni kuwashukuru sana kama venye mmekuja kutuelimisha zaidi. So manake kama mtu hajui unafanya vitu kienyeji. Lakini for now hata venye umeelezea, at least mtu anaweza anza kuzitengeneza, uziangalie vizuri, at least for better performance. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much once again. Here we are at Mbugwa Farm. We were talking about how to be able to take good care of a freshly calved cow with one aim of increasing productivity per cow per herd. And the target is how do we ensure that we achieve the production potential of that cow. It all begins with how we manage this cow immediately the cow just calves down, so that at the end of it all, we're able to achieve high milk synthesis, high milk production, but also bearing in mind the health of the cow, because within actually a very short time, we expect that this cow needs to show symptoms of heat, so that now we're able to serve this cow. Actually, we're targeting not later than 60 days from the day when this cow just calves down. So all that actually leads us to the fact that management of a cow when the cow just gives birth is very, very paramount. It is very, very important in realization of the production potential of the cow. So that is the episode for today. We want to say thank you very much for listening, and we wish you the very best. Thank you very much.